Hello. Nature hasn't made a mistake. I'm going to try and articulate this as best I can. Very difficult subject I'm about to talk about. Nature hasn't made a mistake. In nature, those that deviate from Mother Nature's eternal laws can never become the majority, can they? The obese could never become the majority of any nation, otherwise it would die. Those that opt out of breeding could never become a majority in any society, because within a generation or two, that society wouldn't exist. Criminals couldn't become a majority in any society, because it would tear it apart and there'd be chaos and anarchy. Now, nature, through modern and old societies, I suppose, put barriers in place where those that deviated from nature's eternal laws were only ever a tiny, tiny minority that didn't affect or impact on the bigger population and society in general. Nature had barriers in place. But what's happened is the liberals have taken control of the world and they have removed the barriers, where the obese are becoming more and more. Those opting out of breeding are becoming more and more. Criminals are becoming more and more. And so on and so on. Do you see where I'm coming from? Now, nature will turn this back in the end, but it's whether or not we're destroyed along the way. I don't know. Right? I don't know. Let me put another analogy to you as well, where nature doesn't make mistakes. Let's take the gay community. And it's not a homophobic rant. Trust me, it's not. What percentage of the population can become gay before it starts affecting replacement numbers? You know, breeding the next generation. What percentage of the population can become gay before it starts affecting replacement numbers? 100%? Well, of course not. Only an idiot would believe that. We'd be extinct and bred out within a generation or two. Could the population be 100% heterosexual and continue and thrive? Well, of course it could, right? So therefore, you have to admit then that people following the gay lifestyle, opting out of breeding, can only become a small, tiny minority before it starts affecting the replacement numbers. That means it must be tolerated but not promoted. That means it must be monitored and controlled. You see, nature hasn't made a mistake putting us on the planet to breed and then all of a sudden opting out of it. It hasn't made a mistake. And this is what we're facing now, right? And only chaos can come from this, right? There's nothing other than that can arise out of removing nature's barriers. Like I've said, what's happening now regarding obesity is because barriers have been removed. And many other ills that are now affecting the country, the barriers have been removed by the liberals and screwballs and crackpots. And unless we get back to nature's laws, chaos is on the way. There's no, well, we're seeing it now. Like I've said, nature knew there'd be people that would deviate from it, eternal law. So it made sure there was barriers in place where they didn't become a threat. But what happens when you remove those barriers? Then they become a threat. I'll keep this short and sweet because I don't want to lose track of what I've tried to put across here. It's a difficult subject, this. Like I've said, the laws of nature are eternal. That's why it had barriers in place. The gays were in the closet, not because of homophobia, because nature knew they could become a threat to the bigger population and future generations if they were allowed to go unchecked and become more and more. It's the same with obesity, it's the same with criminals, also with races around the world. Nature didn't create all these races for us to mix together and destroy it all. Nature hasn't made mistakes, it's us making mistakes, and the liberals who've removed the barriers. Okay, thank you.